नमस्कार, अन्योन्याश्यो, मैं हूँ हर्ष और स्वागत है आपका अनदर एपिसोड ऑफ एलकेआई स्टडी इन कोरिया सीरीज। एंड आज हमारे साथ हैं शिखा, जो कि जीस्ट में पढ़ती हैं। जीस्ट इज द शॉर्ट फॉर्म ऑफ ख्वांगजू इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी, एंड इट इज वन ऑफ द फाइव बेस्ट लाइक साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी इंस्टीट्यूट इन कोरिया। एंड सेम लाइक जैसे हमारे यहाँ इंडिया में IITs अलग अलग हैं, वैसे ही कोरिया ने भी अलग अलग सिटीज में दे हैव मेड दिस इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी। तो इसके बारे में और जानेंगे शिखा से एंड इनकी लाइफ स्टाइल एंड हाउ इज द कोर्स एंड एवरीथिंग। तो बिना देर किए हुए चलते हैं शिखा के पास। हेलो शिखा।
हेलो हर्ष।
सो फर्स्ट वी वॉन्ट टू नो दैट वेयर आर यू फ्रॉम इन इंडिया, विच पार्ट एग्जैक्टली यू कम फ्रॉम?
Okay, actually I come from north part of India, from Kanpur city, which is near to New Delhi.
Okay, and how long it has been since you came to Korea?
Okay, so first I came to Korea in 2016 as intern. So, but after that I came back again to Korea for my PhD in 2017. So you can say almost 3.5 years.
So you stayed continuously from 2016 or?
No. So first I came in 2016 summer. Then I stayed for 3 months. Then I went back again to India. Then I came back in 2017, end of the March. After that, I stayed continuously here. But yeah, visiting India every year.
And what was the inspiration to come to Korea? Like, what is the reason behind that you decided to come to Korea for your studies?
So as I mentioned before, like I came first in 2016 as interns, right? So I was selected as one of the intern from one of the labs here at GIST. That was the first time I came to Korea. After that, when I came here and I saw the lifestyle and lab members and lab people and how the facilities GIST is providing. So I was quite impressed in the Korean style and all. So I was quite impressed so that I decided to continue my PhD, my studies here in Korea at GIST. So, yeah.
And what course are you in? What is your exactly the major?
Okay, I am right now PhD student in computer science.
Computer science. Yeah. Okay. And how do you like GIST? How do you like your university? How do you?
Pretty much. I like GIST for several reasons because first of all, we have really good labs here. The research work is so good. And as you mentioned, like this is actually one of the top top institutes in Korea, right? So the facilities is that level. And of course, the professors and labs and lab people and the laboratory facilities, whatever you need, you will get it to do your research. And so if you want to do a good quality research, I think this is good choice to come here. So I pretty like all the facilities provided by them.
So you're doing your PhD, you're getting some scholarship, some specific fund?
Yeah,
or something.
Definitely. That is another positive point here. Like they are providing pretty much good scholarship here. First of all, we are getting two kind of, not scholarships, you can say salaries. First is a scholarship provided by Korean government to graduate students. Mm-hmm. And second one is provided by the professors to all lab people. So we actually get to kind of you can say salary every month.
That's
this is really enough for surviving as a student here, as they're providing dormitory and even they're providing married apartment to married students as well. So I think they are giving a lot of facilities to stay here and do your quality research here. So I'm pretty impressed with that. So I don't need to even ask my parents for my expenses or anything. So we can actually manage to live by our own totally.
That sounds nice. Yeah.
How
is the lifestyle other than the university or lab or research? How is the social life there back in GIST or nearby?
At GIST only or in Gwangju or in general in Korea?
Your lifestyle back there, like how how do you?
First of all, the weekdays is always, most of them are busy because of the lab work. But yeah, mostly. So during this time, because this is pandemic situation, before that, everything was so good. Everybody knows that. Everything was so perfect. So mostly weekends, I was going with my friends to visit some places. And because Korea is really beautiful, the nature and beauty is so beautiful to for sightseeing, for anything. I really enjoy going there and everything. So before this pandemic, everything was so normal. Meeting friends, enjoying, and actually in Gwangju, there is center like Gwangju International Center, GIC.
Right.
And they also, every weekend, they arrange some events for international. Even Koreans can also join. That is not a big deal. But all of us, like we met people there, so many people, we enjoy the event together. We do a lot of gatherings together. So just to communicate and to know each other. So I think it's quite good.
Nice. And how about, are there other Indians also studying in back in your university, back in GIST?
Yeah, we have many Indian students, but we have more postdocs than students, in especially at GIST. Okay. From India. So students are, Indian students are less than postdocs. So, but still, it's quite good. We have community, we gather for Diwali celebration or Holi celebration. We actually gather together and then we do some celebration. So nice. It's like that.
So these were all the positive points. I wanted to ask, like, when you came here, like in Korea, so was there any difficulty you faced in the settling down here?
That's a really good point to ask. Actually, yeah, it's not, everything is not positive. Definitely, I will say that. Mm-hmm. There is negative point of living here, which I can say, which I felt also, it's about language. First of all, that is the biggest problem here. Because of the language, like communication is not quite like, it's not so smoothly communication with other people, with especially Korean people. If you know international students or international people, you can communicate with them so easily. There's no problem at all. But if you're living in Korea, you need to communicate with like normal people in Korean people. You cannot, so communicating with them is quite challenging if you don't know the language. So personally, I felt if people who are learning Korean before coming here, or even who learns Korean 1 year, then they continue their studies, they are doing pretty well than us who doesn't learn and who just directly came to Korea without knowing any Korean language or anything. So that can be the negative point for people who is directly coming without knowing the language. So you need a little language. You need to know little about it. But I use translator and I have many friends who help me. So better make some Korean friends who knows Korean plus English as well. So they will actually, they help you a lot. But personally, at my institute, like GIST, I don't face the problem of language problem inside of my institute, because the classes, professors, lab meetings, and most of the things are always conducted in English. And if you have some trouble in language, they always help us. Like if there's some, of course, documentation comes in Korean, but you have lab members who will help you. And sometimes the office people also, they will translate it for you. So mostly I didn't face much problem of English inside the campus. But the time you get out of the campus, of course, you're going to feel it. And you will definitely feel like, oh no, I should have known this language. I want to communicate with them. But that time you will feel bad. And the other thing was, I am vegetarian. So here comes the other problem. Mostly people, they like Korean food. That's not a big problem here. The people who are non-vegetarian, they can eat, they can survive. Not big problem. But as being vegetarian, I'm facing problem of food as well. Because vegetarian food, you cannot find out. That's really, really hard. So what I do, I actually go to, you can go actually, they are very nice. If you say to them, you don't eat this, they will not put, they will not put any meat. They will not put any seafood or not even egg or anything, but you need to explain. Right. And they will understand and they will not put that. But that food also is not like, it will be normal food. It will not be tasty at all because they're all food contains meat, all of them. Even normal like noodles also contains meat here. Like the spices contains it.
Right, so okay.
That is quite difficult part for being vegetarian. Other than that, who is non-vegetarian, they can easily survive here. That's not a problem.
Nice.
Oh, but there is very strong point here, which I really want to say to all of them. Korea is very, very safe. So
that was
first
actually
time when,
my next question. What do you like the most about Korea?
So yeah, I would definitely like to answer this question. I was waiting for this question to answer actually, because that is the, whenever someone asks me, what is, like you asked me, what is the most you like about Korea? So first I mentioned, always I mentioned, I have been mentioning this, and today also I will mention that, it's safety. So when I was coming out of my country or out of my city, far from my family and all, the first concern, as being even girl, I will say even for boys also, like family will start thinking about safety. But on safety purpose, they don't need to even care about this thing. It's so, so safe. As a girl, I'm also saying it's so safe. So you don't need to, parents or family, they don't need to care about your safety, because Korea is so safe. People are so nice. Even though they don't know your language, they will try to help you in all the way they can. But yeah, this is really the most I like about Korea.
Okay. This question is actually, you also mentioned it before, but still, like, what do you think is the one most important factor for Indians to survive here? You already mentioned some things, but what is the most important one?
Okay, because I think food can be manageable. That, because we have so many international vendors and everything, mm-hmm. that I think that, because I am surviving 3.5 years, even I still am vegetarian, people actually turns into non-vegetarians. I think people can survive. That's not a problem. And as I mentioned, the language, actually, I will say the language is the most important thing to survive here. So if you know the language, your life will be so frequent. It will go so smoothly. You will be able to do everything. Still, I feel difficulty in so many aspects because of the language. Food, I can still survive because there are options. Now I know those options. So I can still survive. But I actually feel many times, hey, what if I know the language? That everything will be more easier. So that would I say. But still, they can survive even with the language problem. Like I do, I use translator. There's so many translators, Google Translator, PapaGo Translator.
Right.
So the people are ready to overcome these difficulties, like especially the language problem, I think this is really great place to come, really great, to study well, to do your good research, quality research. Other than that, everything is so good.
Nice. So before coming to Korea, what was your impression? Like हमारा होता है कि पहले यार ये कोरिया जाना है, कैसी कंट्री है, लोग बताते हैं, there are things. So what was your impression before and how it has changed now?
Oh my God, that is a funny story, you know, as being Indian, we like, when you were coming here to Korea and you tell people you're going to Korea, actually everybody knows Korea is a developed country, but it's still a very small country. People will think in that way. They won't give more preferences or something. So I was also like one of them. Okay, I'm going to Korea. It's fine. It's okay. I might survive. There will be no big deal. I have friends. They will help me. But when I came here, the things were... another thing. The first thing comes... People actually compare the Indian money and Korean currency. So they actually think you will take a little money, you will have a lot of money in Korea. That also, I also thought. And I came with some exchange money from Indian to Korean currency. When I arrived here, believe me, I didn't know, like, it is quite expensive. Like, it's not like you're going to get a lot of things within 10 rupee or 20 rupee. You cannot get anything in 10 or 20 rupee. People actually convert and they found, oh, we will get this much Korean won in this. And we can buy so many things, a lot of things. But that's not true, friends. That's not true. Yeah, it's expensive. Means you can say it's like if you're spending hundreds and thousand Indian rupee, here you are expending 1 lakh and 10,000, it's so normal. It's comparable like that. 10,000 and 100 rupees are same here. 10,000 Korean won and 100 rupee, you can compare. It's like that. So don't fall into this thing. Don't worry. They actually provide the scholarship in that ratio also. So you will get enough money to survive here. So don't get scared about that too. And Yeah, it is a small country, but it is really beautiful country. Really beautiful. Really beautiful places to see. And you will find so many events for you where you can develop yourself, like personally and personality and everything. Even actually, we also have just so many events we organize. And they, in our institute especially, we have clubs for many for students. And we have a special club for international students. So there we organize events for international students to make them feel like good. They are not from different country or something. They always try to make us feel good. So I was also actually the representative of international student last year from JIST. Nice. And the president of the club as well at the same time. So I actually had really good experiences. Of course, bad things also will be there. But I will say I had good experience here. Yeah.
So would you recommend JIST to our Indian students who want to come to Korea for studies or something?
Yeah, definitely. I will recommend to those people who are ready to fight for their for their research or anything, and who are ready to overcome these shortcomings like language or food, and they really want to do some good research. They are lacking, they are feeling, oh, we will need money or something. How will we survive there? So I would like to tell your friends, there will be no such problem if you can overcome those things. And you will have money to survive and everything. You don't need to care about the money. You will have to just care about your research. So you can get good research here. If you want to do that, then please come here.
So for the scholarship, like they can come here, they can come to the university, they can apply there. And then after that, they can like get it, right? They don't have to apply it in the advance or something like that.
No, but there are like application process. They open the applications twice in a year. I cannot tell more about undergrad admission, but I can tell about graduate admission, master's and PhD admissions. Mm-hmm. So in this process, they open the application twice in a year. Then you can apply applying from India and here. If you're here, you can apply from here as well. Then after application, it will go through the whole process. Then it will be selected. After getting selected, if you're selected as graduate students, you will get a scholarship if you are selected. And you will be assigned to a lab. And the lab means your professor will give you another salary from the lab. So you will actually start getting those two salaries on the basis of your selection.
So do you have any specific recommendation to Indian students, like when they are applying, they have to follow something properly, or what they need to do the most, you know, what is the most important thing to get the scholarship or?
Okay. Actually, if you are applying here, I can tell you about just KAIST and these institutes, which are top institutes here in Korea. In their admission process, they have to first send, I would prefer they should actually first contact to the professor with their CV. They should make a good CV and like impressive CV and send to them and ask about the position and all. And they can have interview with them. And that will be helpful for their further university or institute application process. If the professor is impressed by your interview and CV, after interview and CV, and that can make easier for you to get admission in these institutes. So that will I recommend, like first contact to the professor, which you like, which lab you like, first search for the labs according to your area of research, and then contact to those professors about your, like you willing to join or something, and then have interview with them. And if you like the professor or professor likes you as well, then you can further continue your admission process. So that will make easier for you to get admission here.
Thank you so much for giving your precious time. I think it should help our viewers.
Thank you for inviting. It is nice to talk to you here.